Hello and welcome to this session. In this session, we'll discuss rational and exponential inequalities. First of all, let us discuss rational inequality. Now, rational inequality is of the type P upon Q is greater than or equal to 0, P upon Q is less than equal to 0, P upon Q is greater than 0, and P upon Q is less than 0, where P and Q are non-zero polynomials. Now when right hand side of inequality is 0, it is also called standard form of the inequality. Now, rational inequalities are solved in the same way as we solved quadratic inequalities. The only difference is in the critical numbers. We include zeros of the denominator in our list of critical values, but we do not include the critical values given by denominator in the solution set, because at that value the denominator will be 0 and the function P upon Q will not be defined at that point. Thus, zeros of the denominator are also called restrictions. Now, we will follow some steps to find solution set of the rational inequality. In step 1, write the given inequality in standard form. That is, we will make the right hand side of the given inequality equal to 0. Then, in second step, find all real zeros of polynomials P and Q known as critical values. Then, in next step, we will plot all real zeros of polynomials P and Q on the number line. Now, in step 4, choose test number in each interval and check the sign of function P upon Q. Then in step 5, construct a sign chart. And in step 6, write the solution set. Now let us see one example. Here we have to solve this rational inequality. Now let us start with its solution. Now to solve this rational inequality, we will follow the steps which we have discussed earlier. Now in step 1, we have to write the given inequality in standard form. But here you can see, right hand side of the given inequality is 0. Thus, it is already in standard form. Now let us start with step 2. Now the given inequality is in the standard form, that is P upon Q is greater than or equal to 0. Now in second step, we have to find all real zeros of polynomials P and Q. That is, we have to find all real zeros of numerator and denominator of this fraction. Now here, polynomial P is equal to x square plus 4x plus 3, and polynomial Q is equal to x square minus 16. Now to find zeros of P and Q, we will equate them to 0 and factorize. So firstly, let us equate P is equal to 0, that is x square plus 4x plus 3 is equal to 0. Now let us factorize it by splitting the middle term. So this is x square plus 3x plus x plus 3 is equal to 0, which implies, now from these two terms, x is common, so it will be x into x plus 3 the whole, and from these two terms, 1 is common, so it will be plus 1 into x plus 3 the whole is equal to 0, which further implies x plus 3 the whole into x plus 1 the whole is equal to 0. So we obtain x is equal to minus 3 or x is equal to minus 1. Now let us put x square minus 16 is equal to 0. So x square minus 16 is equal to 0 implies x square minus 4 square is equal to 0, which further gives x plus 4 the whole into x minus 4 the whole is equal to 0. That is, by applying the formula of a square minus b square, which is equal to a plus b the whole into a minus b the whole. So we have x is equal to minus 4 or x is equal to 4. Thus, the critical values are x is equal to minus 4, 4, minus 3 and minus 1. So in the second step, we have obtained the critical values. Now in the third step, we will plot these critical values on the number line. Now this is the point minus 4. This is the point minus 3. This is the point minus 1. And this is the point 4. Now here you can see that we have used closed dots to represent the points minus 3 and minus 1, but open dots to represent the points minus 4 and 4, because minus 4 and 4 are zeros of the denominator, so they are restrictions and will not be included in solution set. So here these open dots represent that these points are not included in the solution set. And these closed dots represent that the points minus 3 and minus 1 are included in the solution set. Now here you can see these four points divide the number line into five parts. So we have five intervals. First is open interval minus infinity to minus 4, that is this yellow shaded portion of the number line. Then this pink shaded portion of the number line gives us the second interval, which is open interval minus 4 to minus 3. Then next interval is open interval minus 3 to minus 1. Then fourth interval is the open interval minus 1 to 4. And fifth interval is the open interval 4 to infinity. Now in step 4, we will choose test number in each interval and check the sign of the function p upon q. Now let us take the first interval, that is the open interval minus infinity to minus 4. or we can write it as x is less than minus 4. Now let us choose any value lying in this interval. So here let us take x is equal to minus 5, that lies in this interval. Now let us put x is equal to minus 5 in the given inequality. So we have minus 5 whole square plus 4 into minus 5 plus 3 whole upon minus 5 whole square minus 16 is greater than or equal to 0, which implies 25 minus 20 plus 3 whole upon 25 minus 16 is greater than or equal to 0, and this implies 8 upon 9 is greater than or equal to 0, which is true. So this interval is the solution set of the given inequality. Now let us take the second interval, that is the open interval minus 4 to minus 3, or we can write it as minus 4 is less than x is less than minus 3. Now let us take any value lying in this interval. So here let us take x is equal to minus 3.5. Now let us put x is equal to minus 3.5 in the given inequality. So we have minus 3.5 whole square plus 4 into minus 3.5 plus 3 whole upon minus 3.5 whole square minus 16 is greater than or equal to 0. Now on simplifying, we get 1.25 upon minus 3.75 is greater than or equal to 0, which is false. So this interval is not the solution set of the given inequality. Now let us take the next interval, that is the open interval minus 3 to minus 1, or we can write it as minus 3 is less than x is less than minus 1. Now here let us take any value lying in this interval. So let us take x is equal to minus 2. Now again, let us put x is equal to minus 2 in the given inequality. Now when we put x is equal to minus 2 in the given inequality, we get 1 upon 12 is greater than or equal to 0, which is true. So this interval is the solution set of the given inequality. Now let us take the next interval, that is the open interval minus 1 to 4, or we can write it as minus 1 is less than x is less than 4. Now here let us take x is equal to 0. Now when we put x is equal to 0 in the given inequality, we get 3 upon minus 16 is greater than or equal to 0, which is false. So this interval is not the solution set of the given inequality. Now let us take the next interval, that is the open interval 4 to infinity, or we can write it as x is greater than 4. Now let us take any value that lies in this interval. So here let us take x is equal to 5. Now put x is equal to 5 in the given inequality. Now when we put x is equal to 5 in the given inequality, we get 48 upon 9 is greater than or equal to 0, which is true, so this integral is the solution set of the given inequality. Now in the next step, we will construct sign chart. Now on number line, we see that in the interval, that is the open interval minus infinity to minus 4, we have positive sign for the function p upon q. Then in the open interval minus 4 to minus 3, we have negative sign for the function p upon q. Now in the open interval minus 3 to minus 1, we have positive sign for the function p upon q. Then in the open interval minus 1 to 4, we have negative sign for the function p upon q. And in the open interval 4 to infinity, we have positive sign for the function p upon q. Now in step 6, we have to write the solution set. Now here you can see that the function p upon q is positive in the open intervals minus infinity to minus 4, minus 3 to minus 1, and 4 to infinity. So we have these three intervals in the solution set, and also we know that the points minus 3 and minus 1 are included in the solution set because the given inequality is greater than or equal to, and also these are, that is minus 3 and minus 1 are zeros of numerator. So solution set is open interval minus infinity to minus 4 union closed interval minus 3 to minus 1 union open interval 4 to infinity. Now let us discuss exponential inequality. Now we will see how can we solve an exponential inequality graphically. Now suppose we have to solve 7 raised to power x is less than 12 for x. Now here you can see that the right hand side cannot be written in powers with same base 7. Thus we use graph to solve it. Now using graphic calculator, we see that this is the graph of the equation y is equal to 7 raised to power x. Now here you can see when y is equal to 12, then x is equal to 1.277. When x is greater than 1.277, then y is equal to 7 raised to power x is also greater than 12, and when x is less than 1.277, then y is equal to 7 raised to power x is also less than 12. Thus from graph we have 7 raised to power x is less than 12 if x is less than 1.277. Thus solution set is the open interval minus infinity to 1.277. Now suppose we have to solve 7 raised to power x is less than 343. Now here you can see that right hand side can be written in powers of base 7. Thus we have 7 raised to power x is less than 7 raised to power 3. Now we can equate the powers because we have same base. Thus x is less than 3. So for x is less than 3 we have 7 raised to power x is less than 343. So its solution set is the open interval minus infinity to 3. So in this session we have discussed rational and exponential inequalities, and this completes our session. Hope you all have enjoyed the session.